If you were to go to any part of the country and talk to people about Novi, you know, they would say, oh, the Novi race car is, we know Novi because of the Novi race car. What people don't realize is that was the most famous race car at Indianapolis from the mid-40s to the mid-60s. I mean, it has a very important heritage down there.
The big thing that we're famous for is the Novi Special, which ran in the Indianapolis 500, and that's always been Novi's claim to fame.
The Novi Special is called the greatest car to never win the Indy 500. Yet, it still managed to become an Indianapolis icon without ever entering the winner's circle.
The Novi part of the car is the engine, because it's a one-of-a-kind double overhead cam supercharged motor that was made as a motor. I mean, it wasn't a car engine or somebody else's engine. It was a one-of-a-kind engine. The part of the car that was really special is in its earlier years, the supercharger. I guess it made a sound like a siren. You could hear it for 10 miles away, they claimed.
A fan favorite due to its overwhelming power and sound. The crowds loved the high-pitched shriek of the Novi engine.
I remember, you know, my father turning the radio on, and he says, well, they're getting ready to start the big Indy race, he says, and boy, we hope that Novi car wins the race this year.
The origins of the Novi Special can be traced back to the 1930s. In 1937, the Indianapolis 500 ended its junk car formula, which was put in place during the Depression to allow cheaper engines to compete in the race. With the restrictions lifted, brothers Ed and Bud Winfield wanted to build a new Indy car. They landed sponsorship from Lou Welch, owner of Novi Equipment Company.
Lou Welch was a manufacturer of parts for Ford Motor Company, more specifically Ford tractor parts. He was a friend of Henry Ford. If you look at the old Novi race cars, the Ford V8 logo was on the front of the car. I guess he had permission from Henry Ford to use the V8 logo on his cars. He had the engines designed and built. They weren't designed and built here, but they were headquartered here. That's where the water tower is.
The engine, designed by Bud Winfield and Leo Goosen, and built by Fred Offenhauser, was first used under the Winfield name for the 1941 race. It was immensely powerful and produced an output of over 450 horsepower, much higher than the typical 300 horsepower for the other engines in the field. The front drive Novi was heavy, thirsty, and extremely hard on its tires. Thus, the car proved incredibly difficult to control. Lou Welch originally chose Ralph Hepburn, an experienced Indy driver, to drive his new car. Hepburn managed a respectable fourth place in the 1941 race. Other drivers such as Chet Miller, Paul Russo, and Duke Naylor drove the car at notable speeds, but none of them ever won a race. Tragedy struck in 1948 during a practice run when Hepburn lost control of his Novi and crashed head-on into a wall. He was killed instantly. The Novi had begun to build a reputation for being jinxed. Duke Naylor drove the Novi that year and was the fastest qualifier for the race. With only 13 laps to go, Naylor had to stop to refuel. He ended up finishing in third place, which would become the best ever result for the Novi engine. During the 1949 race, Naylor crashed his Novi into the wall, leaving a fiery inferno in his wake. He barely escaped, diving out of the car at the last second and surviving the crash with severe burns and bruises. Bud Winfield was fatally injured in a traffic crash in 1950. The Novi team lost their lead mechanic and the heart and soul of the team. After failing to qualify in 1950, Duke Naylor returned to claim the pole for the 1951 race. Yet again, engine failures plagued the car, causing the Novi to retire early. The 1952 race again saw the Novi Special qualify for the pole position, but both cars broke their drive shafts during the race and retired early. In 1953, the Novi claimed another life. Chet Miller crashed his Novi into the wall during a practice run, strangely familiar to the accident that claimed Hepburn's life. The Novi would fail to qualify for a race until 1956, when they switched to a rear-wheel drive. The car held a brief lead until a blown tire knocked it out of the race early. For 20 years, Lew Welch chased an elusive win at Indianapolis with the Novi Special. In 1961, he sold the Novi assets to Andy Granatelli for a reported $10,000. Granatelli's work on the car would see record outputs of over 700 horsepower. In 1963, Paula Murphy became one of the first women to drive at the Indianapolis Motor Speedway when Granatelli had her run some tire tests in his new Novi racer. Bobby Unser would be the last driver to race the Novi in the Indy 500 in 1965. The car failed to qualify for the 1966 race, thus marking the end of the ill-fated Novi's odyssey, one that had promised so much but delivered so little.
When I went to the Indy 500 wearing a jacket that said Team Novi on it, I could not believe the number of people from other states that came up to me and said, "You are from Novi? You're from Novi, of the Novi Special Engine?" And I started to go, wow, everybody knows about it more than I do. Of course, Ed Crewell, really, he really knew a lot about it and had researched a lot about the engine itself. And it was his goal to, we got to have one of these. You know, it belongs here.
I tracked the Novi stable down to Andy Granatelli in Van Nuys, California, and I talked to his son, Vince, and I said, "Where's all the Novi race cars?" He says, "Well, the museum's got a couple. We've got all the engines and transmissions," and, you know, we said, "We've got it all here."
Through shrewd negotiating, Ed Crewell eventually brought a fully working Novi Special back to the city. Funded by donations from Spike Walker, a local businessman, and the Novi Economic Development Corporation, Novi now owns the car that bore its name.
You know, our car is a running car. It did a couple of laps at MIS one year during one of the races there. You know, we just slowly went around the track, but we ended up with the last Novi, fully restored, no tax dollars involved. You know, that was a good thing for the city. And it is the most important historical thing about Novi when you really get down to it. I mean, because it's a big deal.